Hi everybody, I just want to show you that I have filled out my second sketchbook, my watercolor sketchbook. So I have video about the first one up that I did like a year ago. So this is a moleskin one. It was a gift from a lovely sub. So yeah, and just some info about me, where I live and stuff. Anyway, so let's just dive into it. So my first picture I did with the Cutman watercolors. I will just flip through this quite fast. So this is a mountain and a whale. Yeah, I guess that you can see it yourself. Yeah, I tried out some loose flowers, and painting loose is really hard, but it was quite fun to test out. This I followed a tutorial by Lindsay the Perugal crafter. So of a little long-eared bunny there. And then we have a coyote, followed the book from Dana Fox, the watercolor with me in the forest. So many of these are from that book. This is another fox with Cutmans, and then we have a beaver, also from Dana Fox's book. This is the graphite tint. I just sketched out a lighthouse because I wasn't going to make like a big painting, and then I just sketched out this first and to see kind of. Yeah, what I have wanted. This is a dragonfly. We have it is a ink and wash drawing. So you will see them later as well. So here is just a colorful flower or leaf. I mean, this is a we call it anemone. I don't know the English word for it, but this is a magnolia bud that I don't know who it is. So this is a stoat, again an ink and wash picture, another one, some kind of reptile, and pine cone. So all of these are in the Dana Fox book, Bob Watercolor Behind Me in the Forest. A little mice. Some cherries, and I'm quite cheap on my book, so I watercolor on both sides. I got some Daniel Smith from actually two persons. Well, first from one person, and then I just tested them out and had a little go with them here. And I didn't have that many colors. I think it was like 3 or 4 colors. So I just tested them out and had a go with them here, and they are amazing paints. Later on I got some more from a parent, so I have discovered how awesome Daniel's and Summit paints are. This is a picture that I use my Georgian watercolor pocket sketchbook that from Dale and Ronnie, which are now 31 years old or something. So that paint actually still works, so I was amazed, and it was so much fun painting that. Testing out some kiwi. This is with my Gadams, which is still my favorite painting. Dele Aroni, here I was testing out some brushes and some techniques. Just having fun. Like, this is a sketchbook. This is not meant to be completed paintings. So some of them are. So this is the whole barn where I'm practicing some vetten they'll be the mixing. Again, this is the escape No, cascade green from Daniel Smith, which is just a color that just amazes me, because all of this is actually one color, and it just gives you so much of variety from blue and green and some gold and brown color. That is just one amazing paint. So when I have found out this, I had to get myself a big tube of it. So I did get some tubes. Just a mountain, practicing and having some fun. A purple paprika, or yeah, something. I found the picture on Pinterest, I think it was. Practicing the inside of some woods. That was so much fun. I followed a tutorial for that one as well. And printing this one. This is actually used. I used the Vincent and Newton professional painting things, and you can see the granulation down here, given that pattern. I just love that paint and that effect that it gives. Testing out my watercolor brush pens together with my Lyra Aqua brush duo did not work quite as I wanted, and just testing out both some mixing of some colors and sample or different brushes. I think I started follow the doodle wash prompts here, so I made some a couple of pairs. That was so much fun to do, and we had pop, so I tried to make a little pop myself. This is also with the cutmans. Again, I did a doodle wash, and so this over here is some mushrooms, and then we I think I was the bird, or yeah, eyes, I guess. I was supposed to make two, but so if you don't look at that thing over there, then I'm quite happy with it. Done with the Daniel Smith and some ink pens. And I don't know if you can see, but the mountain in here is actually shimmering. I don't think that camera can pick it up. Next prompt was art supply, so I drew some paints as I painted with them. I did this, I think it was the water that the prompt was, so I made this. This is my water with a mermaid swimming up and some fishes of different kinds. We have an owl. This is also with the cutmans, and we have some leaves. This one I did with the holbeins that Kenny gave me. I just love that paint. It is amazing. So holbeins and M.G.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K.K. have to use everything else. Nuts, so I did some couple of some, I guess that's called acorns. And the prompt was octopus, so I drew and painted one myself. Flowers, I did not really like that one as much. It did not quite go as I wanted it, because it is supposed to be some shimmery paints, but it did not really work. So I did some loose flowers and then I posted them instead. Watermelon, but and the prompter was actually berries, and when I googled berries, watermelon actually came up, and then I started reading, and watermelons is actually a berry. So I never knew that, so I learned something new. Next up was the village, so I did this one. So this is my little village. Children now, since I don't do portraits in watercolor spectrum sketch, I really can't paint children, so it had to be like this to on the beach. I think it was trees was the prompt here, so I made a silvery forest. You can see the shimmer in it. This was so much fun. Panda. Again, my animals is, I need to work on them. The drawing is really not my thing. Palm garinate. I had so much fun finding the image and practicing to see the colors and the under layers and stuff. So I actually learned so much by doing this. That was so much fun. A little raccoon. Also had such a hard time drawing him. Yeah. But I'm getting it better and better. Just a little from my hometown. This is the North Cape. The parent was mountains, and this is one of the mountains that I grew up with. So we have a penguin. I think he came out so cute. Then the plant was mug, and I painting coffee mugs is not really me, so I so my mind started working, and I was like, what is mug and mugging muggers, and then I was like, oh my god, I can paint, I can make somebody mug someone. So my idea behind this is that these two rabbits are mugging the snow man for his carrot nose. So yeah, that's my interpretation of mug. This is a little deer. My pink giraffe, which really looks more like a pig than a giraffe, but it was a fatty hand sketch, and yeah, again, my animals. I like making them cute like this one. I find that to be so much fun, and the boarding. So this is supposed to be a turtle. So we have I don't even know how to say it, gourds or something. I had to Google this word because I never have heard about it, because yeah, and aubergines and squash and yeah, those two things are gourds. But then I learned that they come in so many different sizes and shapes and patterns, and it's just an amazing vegetable thing. Yeah, so I'm learning quite a lot of new stuff. So this is a pineapple. Again, the cutesy stuff is fun. A turkey. I guess that was on Thanksgiving. We don't have that here, but and then we was supposed to make a dessert, and so I made my favorite dessert in the whole world, which is a world's best cake. It's called the world's best cake. So looks like that. I'm quite happy with it. Then it was fairy tale, and we have this Norwegian fairy tale called Kvite Bjørn Kong Valemon, which is a story about this cursed p- 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 parents that was questioned to be to a polar bear, and this parents had to marry him. So it's a lovely fairy tale. This is just some paddy hand mountains and just having some fun, testing out different things, checking tarad hands, and glass was the next. Oh, I'm so sorry. Was the next word, and so I made a glass window, stained glass window with watercolors. I did some Christmas wreaths in or with my whole bands. This was so much fun. I really enjoyed doing this. I followed a tutorial from Let's Make Art, I think it was. So that was quite easy. Just testing out my watercolor brushes to test them for colors and stuff. The mixing abilities. Again, this is a sketchbook, so I'm also just tested stuff when I didn't have anything out there, paper or yeah. So here I'm mixing ultramarine and the carabine rose in different ways. So, this is a humpback whale. Here Dana Fox have given out the book Watercolor with Me in the Ocean or in the Sea. No, I think it's ocean. And so she made this humpback whale, which I love to test out. That was just so much fun. She also have a sea turtle, so I did this one, and it just looks so goofy with that smile. And yeah, and we have a hermit crab. I learned quite a lot by doing this one as well. I really love Dana Fox's books because they are so simple and so yeah. I made a wave. This is with gouache actually. Just testing out to see that you can put them on top, and yeah, I just had some fun with that. And the same here, again gouache, testing colors and layering, and yeah. So, and this I actually did this morning just to have some fun. So that's it. That was my completed sketchbook number 2. So now I have to I have this awesome Ekter sketchbook that is waiting for me, this white one. So I'm just, yeah, I just can't wait to dive into that. Yeah, I think that's it. Thank you everybody so much for watching, and I hope that you enjoyed this, and that all of you have a happy new year whenever you are having that. So until next time, put color on something, and I will see you all later. Bye.